Hello, 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 greetings, salutations, konnichiwa, and every other form of greeting across this vast, marvelous multiverse. I am Matsu Quinox, this is Horus, and welcome back, my dear, wonderful scholars, once again, to the study. Glad to have you all here. Hello there, Yulian, welcome, and hello there, Dr. Zadium, welcome, welcome, glad to see you here. 20, how come I can't hear you? Firefly, evening. Oh, hello there, Firefly, welcome. Hello there, Solar Coast, welcome. Hello there, Private Macro, welcome as well. And hello there, Jewelry Jelly, welcome. Oh my goodness, I'm glad you could hear me just fine. I was a little worried there for a second. Oh, I don't want any technical difficulties to be happening. Oh my goodness. So how are all you fine, wonderful scholars doing? I hope you're all doing well. So it calls Yulian, are you sure your Twitch audio isn't turned down? Dr. Zadium, congratulations on 100 videos. Yes, we have done 100 videos uploaded on YouTube. If you didn't know, I do have a YouTube channel. It's mostly VODs, but it does have some original content in there, including a short in the study, and I'm planning some more that'll be just found there on that channel. So if you would like to, please subscribe. So it goes, I'm alright, a little tired though. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Well, I hope this tonight's stream might awaken you a little bit. Or not. Might put you to sleep. You can never tell. Today has been, well, it's been a day. Horus and I were, dealing with some visitors, including one with a lot of demands, I'll tell you that. We finally managed to get things straightened out, though, and managed to salvage what was left of this fine, wonderful time. But yes. Today, well, if there isn't anything else for me to say, today we are going to be continuing our playthrough of the Stanley Parable. I was trying to remember this. I almost said something else. My brain's a little bit off today, I'll tell you that. Yes, the Stanley Parable. So last time we played, we managed to... Well, let's be honest. We managed to anger the narrator, which was quite fun to do, actually. I think it was quite fun to actually ignore the narrator and explore on our own. We've got to play some games that that we might not have been able to play if we didn't. I mean, I've never actually played Firewatch, but this looks fascinating, if that's... Well, it is. Oh, my goodness. Oh. But yes, my dear scholars, tonight we'll be playing more. I don't know, to be honest, if we'll ever 100% this game, which I will explain once we get into it. So then, my dear, wonderful, fantastic scholars, do you think we should delve right into the office universe of the Stanley Parable? I keep wanting to say Stanley Paradigm. I don't know why. Maybe because both start with a P and it sounds very businesslike. I don't know. Dr. Zadium says yes. Oh, interesting. Eager. Alright then, my dear scholars. Well then, let's head over to the gaming room and I'll get everything set up. In the meantime, let me get it booted up a little bit beforehand so we don't run into any problems. I hope. Takes a while for this thing. Let's give it a second. There we are. Okay. And we will head over. No. What are you doing over there? There we are. Ah, think I was seeing dull there for a second. Ooh, the silver. Please, just Dr. Zadium. Matsu obliterated reality. That happens a lot more than you'd expect. Please adjust the slider till the computer is barely visible. Think that's good enough. I mean, I can barely see it. Please adjust the slider until the dog and the cat are friends. Aww. Please adjust the slider until the number 5 becomes the number 9. What happens if we adjust it all the way over? We'll go with that 9. Please adjust the slider until you stop adjusting the slider. Oseo, welcome. Oh, we have a improvise a story. All right, then. Let's see. Well, since this is an office setting, let's do an office story then. It had been a long day at the office for Robert. He had almost forgotten what time it was. He sat there in his office, looking up at the clock. I say, oh, can it be a love story? Oh, certainly. Wondering, perhaps they wouldn't come. Perhaps there was nothing left for him. Perhaps this was it. Perhaps this was all that he had. He was gazing up the clock when suddenly he noticed it seemed to change. It seemed to grow larger and larger till it filled up his entire eyes. And then, you know what? Can I start from the beginning again, Aseo? Because this story that I'm improvising, it's not coming out quite like I wanted it to. You wanted a love story, didn't you? Okay, let's do something a little more fantastical. Okay, let me think of one. Give me a second. Trying to think of a good story for this. Dr. Zayn, tell us of the forbidden love of the smiley stone of the playground. No! Oh, I got one. I've got a story. I got a story. She held on tight to the edge of the cliff. Below was an ever-increasing chasm. Above her, she could see her partner, the man who she had followed into the temple. He had only seemingly agreed on the for the purpose of finding the artifact. Still, she had reluctantly gone along. After all, this had been his idea. Reaching up, she managed to grab his hand. He pulled her to her feet, and they both looked forward. The hall was dismal and dark, the carvings alongside just too suspicious. We're gonna have to make a run for it, he said. Wish I didn't have to. I'm already exhausted as it is, she said. Well, do you want to stay here? He remarked. She gave a smirk. Not on your life. They crouched down, taking a deep breath. With all their energy, they bolted forward. They weren't even sure what the trap was. They didn't look back. All they knew was they nearly tripped alongside the stone staircase that led above them. It was long, it was tall. It seemed to go on forever. But they climbed. And they climbed and they climbed. Till at last, they reached the great pillar, where the diamond lay in perfect carving. It glinted with a light unseen by man for nearly 1,000 years, but to them it was all too familiar. They caught their breath and turned to each other. He gave a weary smirk and said to her, "You know, do we have to do this every single date? I mean, I'm getting pretty tired of going after this diamond." She smiled and put her hand on his cheek. "Well, it was your idea." She gave him a gentle kiss and took the diamond and put it back in her backpack. "Next time," she said, "you put it in the on the pillar. I did that last time." The end. Quite a silly, strange story, I'll admit, but I'm not an expert in romance, let's be honest. Horace is more the romantic type around here. Archer, isn't that right, Horace? Well, I see the stuff you write. Don't try and deny it. You should publish it. I mean, that is a compliment, Horace. Honestly, he's a very good writer. He just doesn't like to talk about it. Okay, which of these two made-up words below is the most appealing to me? Akabunikal or Scrumtush? Well, obviously Scrumtush. Please don't adjust this slider. I'm a rebel. Do you know what time it is right now? More or less. Is the time that is right now the correct time? Yes. What is the time anyway? What is time anyway? Is there anything about yourself that you haven't told me? No. Help. Will you come to back to visit me? Okay, let's begin the game again.
This is the story of a man named Stanley.
As we heard before.
Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427.
A nice round number.
Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427 and he pushed buttons on a keyboard. Orders came to him through a monitor on his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order.
This is depressing.
This is what employee 427 did every day of every month of every year. And although others might have considered it soul-rending, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in, as though he had been made exactly for this job. And Stanley was happy.
Until...
And then one day, something very peculiar happened. Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget. He had been at his desk for nearly an hour, when he realized that not one single order had arrived on the monitor for him to follow. No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi.
Maybe they're just shy.
Never in all his years at the company had this happened, this complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses, he got up from his desk and stepped out of his office.
I'll come back, quit the game, and then start it again. Okay. Alright. Back here with our yellow box. And everything here. Prime Maverick, it's the song that never ends, isn't it? Don't start on that. So, earlier at the start of this stream, I mentioned that we're probably not going to 100% this game. Firefly, I can't hear you over the narrator when he's speaking. Oh. Settings. Wonder if I can turn down the volume.
This is a story of a man named Stanley.
There we are.
This is the story of a man named Stanley.
Okay. So I mentioned before that we're probably not going to 100% this game. And the reason for that is there are 42 endings in this game.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
Can I have that phone? I mean, that's a beautifully green phone, and I love the color green.
Stanley went around touching every little thing in the office, but it didn't make a single difference, nor did it advance the story anyway.
Oh, there's a corner plan. Oh, we can stand on the desk here. Someone's the air conditioning on. Oh, do we just turn off the computer? Oh my goodness. Well, we're saving them power. Dizzying, I'll admit that. Okay. Well, might as well move on. White void. Everyone's got a green phone. Why didn't I get a green phone? Do I have a green phone? I mean, I deserve a green phone. What's that say? Oh. Come on, narrator, talk to me. The narrator's sulking. I know we angered the narrator last time a lot, but still. Oh! Wait, did I just step on... Oh, wow. You know, if your coworkers did disappear, my dear scholars, if your coworkers did disappear out of your office, what would be the first thing you would do? I mean, if you could do anything. I'd probably climb on their desks. Let's be honest, that'd be a lot of fun. And we locked ourselves in. Private Maverick, a good question, really, yeah. Yes, it's a very good question. Firefly, they already have, we all work from home. You know what? Technically, since I'm stuck here in the study, does that mean I work at home? Well, I don't really work, though. Do I work? Well, I suppose the game won't let us go. Nick. If you live there, then yes. Oh my goodness, someone spilled their coffee. What a waste. Is that broken?
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
So, my dear scholars, we have a choice here. Last time we blatantly ignored the narrator. Should we ignore the narrator again and see where it takes us, or should we properly do the story this time? Yulia says no right away. Yulia, did I annoy you last time with the path I took? What say you, my dear scholars? Should we follow the story this time, or should we? Yulian 20, you drove me crazy. I'm sorry. I am so sorry to hear that. Or should we go on our own? Right. Let's do the story. We did the annoyance last time. Firefly, have we followed the narrator yet? Yes, we have followed the narrator. A little bit, so far. Last time we didn't. What happens if I close the doors? Can I close the doors? I can't close the doors. Well, I guess we'll follow it this time a little bit. Because I know there's multiple endings we can get.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
Meeting room floor 4XX. Do not alter without consulting whiteboard manager. Can we climb on this? Trying to figure out if there's anything else we can change in this location. Rate at which charts on the same slide depict the same information. Boss appreciation minute. Door open again? No. What are your dreams of your future? Talk radio, mitosis, pollution, less air, clear skin. Tips for not getting fired. Talk less. Do unbelievably amazing work all the time, every day, with no expectation of promotion or recognition. Don't get fired. How to solve a dispute with a coworker. Let it ball up inside you. Take out passive aggressiveness on other coworkers. Resent coworkers for not supporting you more. Well. Okay. I suppose that's reasonable. Oh, there's the broom closet. We went in there last time.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
I suppose we should follow. I mean, this is fine and all that. What's in the executive bathroom? To be rich, is it a crime? To commit crimes, isn't it rich? What a life it would be to have to pick just one. It's a nice bathroom. Other than the mirror, which could use a little bit of cleaning. This is a nice bathroom. What do you need this drawers for? I like the painting. It's very Monet-ish. Reminds me of Monet. Can't go back. Oh dear. That's locked. Firefly, where are the where are the books? Where are the books? What kind of office is this? There's a book here. What is it? The beige pages. Books. What kind of place doesn't have a book? Oh. Oh, here they are.
Staring into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this. What dark secret was being held from him? What he could not have known was that the keypad behind the boss's desk guarded the terrible truth that his boss had been keeping from him. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number, 2845. But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this.
Are you trying to tell me something, narrator? Look at all these books! Oh, I don't want to leave this room. Oh, it's got a fireplace! Oh my goodness!
Stanley just sat around twiddling his thumbs. Trying to input anything on the device was useless, since he could never possibly know that the combination was 2845.
Certificate of... I cannot read that.
2845.
Okay, let's see. That number was... Drew Jelly, I think it says pompousness.
Forgot, but it turns out that the panel's emergency override kicked in, and the door just opened all by itself. And Stanley got the hell along with the story. Well, whoop-de-doo.
Someone's not happy with us, I think. someone is in hell. I don't want to go in there. I want to stay in here. There's books. I mean, I can't see the titles, but there's so many books here. I think, my dear scholars, we should stop here for now and just admire this glorious personal library. Private Maverick, do it, leave. Can I leave? No, they locked the door behind you. That is a beautiful library. Some gaps in it, but still, these gaps would be perfect to store more books. Don't you agree? Don't you agree, Horace? You could store all sorts of books here. You could store dictionaries, omnibuses. Oh my goodness. You could even store, dare I say it? Encyclopedias. Oh. Oh, wonder of wonders. Oh my goodness. So Stanley's found his happy place. You need 20 cookbooks. Yes, cookbooks. Kintron. Encyclopedias. Yes, encyclopedias, Kintron. Also, welcome. Look at this. Look at all the spaces. You could fill it with so many encyclopedias. Oh my goodness. The collected works of William Shakespeare. Dickens. Oh. So many. Oh, I just want to... I just want to rub my face up against it. Mm. That sweet, sweet old book smell. Can't get any closer, no. Just rub my face up against it. Oh. Oh, I'm in my happy place. I'm in my happy place. Oh, my goodness. Oh. Firefly, no, not skin oils. It's all right. It's all right. I don't give off skin oils. But oh my goodness. Oh my happiness. I'm going to ignore that because I'm happy. I'm so happy. This is mine. This is all mine. All mine. This makes me so happy. Ooh. Happy, happy, happy book time. Mm. Oh my goodness. So it goes, whoa, settle down there. I think I'm getting high off the books. Oh. What do you think they have the... Oh my goodness. Oh. But I suppose we should get on with the game. I don't want to leave. I don't want to leave. I don't want to leave! Show of hands. Should I stay here in the library forever, or should I actually get on with the game? Kintron sniffing books and hallucinating off old India ink. Yes, yes. Alien 20, leave. Firefly, come back and anger the narrator. Stay, Solarco, stay in the library. Yes, I agree, I'll stay in the library. It's mine. It's all mine. No one can take it away from me. No one can take it away from me. No, I'm staying in there. Mine. All mine. All mine. Mine to click, to feel my touch. I suppose we should keep going, though. We don't want to leave this place, but... fine. I don't know where we are. Reminds me of the under room in the study. Whoa! Right, I'm going.
Descending deeper into the building, Stanley realized he felt a bit peculiar. It was a stirring of emotion in his chest, as though he felt more free to think for himself, to question the nature of his job.
Why am I going down?
Why did he feel this now, when for years it had never occurred?
Why am I getting farther away from the books?
This question would not go unanswered for long.
Firefly, you have a horror basement in your study? Not really a horror basement.
Whoops. Nope. Never mind. Stanley actually got back into the elevator and went back up. Silly me. Why did Stanley do that when he knew that it would just go back to his boss's office? Well, that's a great question. I just can't wait to find out.
Crusader Crupton. Hello, hello, hello. Yes, welcome, Crusader Crupton. We are confusing the heck out of the narrator. I'm going back to my safe spot.
Here we are, Stanley. It's your boss's office. Exactly the way it was before you got onto the elevator. It's still just exactly what it is. What a decision you've made to come up here and look at the office again.
It's got books!
This has fleshed out the plot of the story in new and fascinating ways I could have never anticipated. It's that keen eye for storytelling that you have. Incisive rapid fire of critical plot points, one after the other, weaving a rich tapestry of uncompromising narrative. Wow. I'm bolted to the edge of my seat.
I am too. Kinchon, I should move all my books of ghost stories in the basement. Yes, you should. I wonder, what if we go down the elevator again and we go back up again? I want to see us do that. What happens if we do that?
Incredible. Now he's getting back into the elevator. Ladies and gentlemen, how does he keep coming up with all of this?
You know what? Let's go back up.
Did you think we were going to go forward down the spooky corridor? No. It's time once again to go back up in the elevator. I can't even begin to grapple with what might be up there. Is it the boss's office again? Or what if it's the boss's office this time? The suspense is killing me.
I'm gonna lose it. Horace, help me. Horace, help me.
His office. This absolutely changes everything for me. Give me a time out here for a minute while I process this.
Oh my goodness! We broke the narrator!
Okay, I'm ready. I'm prepared to embrace this stunning revelation and to move forward with... No, wait! No, I need more time to process.
Oh my goodness. This is all cost.
All right. I have fully come to terms with it. I have made space in my worldview for this astonishing new reality. As before, I turn to your expert eye for gripping narrative, Master Stanley.
One more time!
Of course. Going back down the elevator. How did I not anticipate it? I mean, sure, now it's obvious, but you have to understand that 30 seconds ago, this kind of thing had never been attempted before. I had no frame of reference to even anticipate it. That's just how revelatory Stanley's decision-making is. A breath of fresh air in a landscape of storytelling that has grown stale and repetitive.
So for those who came in late, this game has 42 endings to it. And one more time, just for good measure.
You know what? I just thought of something. Hold on, let's stop for a moment. Don't you realize? It's the anticipation, Stanley. You and I, we have no way of knowing what will be at the top of this elevator. But the suspense, the agony of waiting and anticipating and having to guess, that's the real thrill. Oh, I simply don't want to let that feeling go. It's precious, so fleeting. Why don't we take this elevator ride nice and slow? There we go. Isn't this so much more exciting? You know, Stanley, it seems like nowadays the only thing that audiences want is to be shocked as loudly and frequently as possible. They want big, explosive moments flung right in their faces in the same moment the film gets started. But where's the tension? Where's the trust in the audience to build a slow and nuanced appreciation for the story, the characters? Why aren't we given time to imagine the surprises? To have to think and to anticipate and then to marvel at the eventual reveal. This is storytelling, Stanley.
I agree.
What you and I are doing right now, this is the most exciting narrative to be developed in years. And it's really all because of you. You're the one who took this bold step of revisiting the exact same locations over and over. Truly, I mean it. This is unique and different. It's not like anything else out there. You see, I want stories that surprise me, Stanley. I want to have to think. I want to be engaged and not pandered to. We're being fed such unimaginative drivel all the time, and we all know it, which is why we're so starved for content that makes us feel sharp and vital and alive. That's why people like you so much, Stanley, because you're not afraid to spit in the face of tradition. You're a role model, you know? People look up to you, which is why, though I didn't know when to spring this on you, but, well, I've gathered a little press conference for you, so that you can talk about your work and
goodness.
Your storytelling and your life. Yes, I know you're not much for the public eye, but I thought it would especially mean a lot to the people who have been following you from the beginning. They really look up to you, Stanley.
Firefly narrators be paid by the word yes.
You have on them. This is the kind of gesture that might leave a tremendous impact on them for the better.
Oh my goodness. We're here. So I gotta go forward.
Okay, the room where we're holding the press conference should be just around the corner here somewhere.
World's healthiest human beings. How we did the pyramids. Live, the guy who went to Mars. Solar goes suddenly pie to the face. All eyes on Stanley, live on stage. With world peace, maybe.
Ah, yes. Here it is, just through this door.
What happens if I close the door? I can't close the door. Can I go back the way I came? Nope. So I gotta go forward.
I've told them you're going to speak a little bit about the nature of surprise in storytelling and what it means to craft a truly unpredictable narrative. Oh, don't worry. You'll do great. Just be yourself and speak from the heart. I'm really proud of you, Stanley. Okay, it looks like they're ready for you. Go get 'em.
Okay. Oh, so we got another ending. Okay.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
Let's keep
Stanley
moving,
decided
then.
To go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Kinchon, I haven't seen that one before. Hello there, Cool Skeleton. Welcome. You just missed us trigger a new ending. Where apparently we pissed off the narrator enough to...
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
We triggered an ending where we did a press conference because we pissed off the narrator so much.
Yet there was not a single person here either.
We'll get back to where
Feeling
we were.
Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office. Hoping he might find an coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Oh, wait. We'll try and trigger some other ones. Sad that there's nothing that you can do with the executive office, executive bathroom. We already did this part anyway, so let's keep going. Back up. Up, 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 so high. Oh! Didn't go in this place. And what the heck? What the book? Business? That's their business strategy? Cool Skeleton, have we gotten Adventure Line yet? I don't think so. I wonder what this is. Oh, let's go up. I think he is! So close, you're going to the back rooms. No! No, I don't want to go back there. Yeah, he's singing along. There he's singing along. Us right back to where we were. What happens if we go down? Cool Skeleton, essentially this place is all the maze. For say a corrupted old backwards with the power of the narrator would be fun. It would be terrifying. That's what it would be. So the elevator takes you nowhere. except it plays some really swanky music.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. What could it mean? Stanley wondered aloud to nobody. He began wildly tearing through papers on the boss's desk, pulling books off the shelf.
Why would you do that?
Looking behind paintings, desperate for clues to his situation. But his attention was caught by a keypad behind the boss's desk. What could its purpose be? In fact, this keypad guarded the terrible secret that lay buried below his feet. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number, 2845. But of course, Stanley couldn't get it quickly by simply pushing random buttons on the keypad. Stanley happened to input the correct code by sheer luck. Amazing. He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Now. They locked it. Did I press up last time? Oh, well, I can only press down. I forgot about that. Okay. Whoa! Seriously need someone to look in the safety of this place.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
Oh, Mind Control Facility? You know what? No.
Although this passageway had the word escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley would meet his violent death.
Someone's a little bit salty.
The door behind him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track. At this point, Stanley was making a conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his death.
Look. We have a decision. Either go into a place called Mind Control Facility or face our own intimate demise. I think I know which path I'm going to take. Oh well.
Stanley was inched closer and closer to his demise. He reflected that his life had been of no consequence whatsoever. Stanley can't see the big picture. He doesn't know the real story. Trapped forever in his narrow vision.
Yeah, someone seems a little bit annoyed. Don't
perhaps
you agree, my dear scholars?
A great loss, like plucking the eyeballs from a blind man.
Whoa!
So he resigned.
Whoa, narrator.
And willingly accepted this violent end to his brief and shallow life. Farewell, Stanley.
Farewell, Stanley, cried the narrator.
What?
As Stanley was led helplessly into the enormous metal jaws. In a single visceral instant,
okay.
Stanley was obliterated as the machine crushed every bone in his body, killing him instantly.
What just happened? Hello? Okay. Narrator! Narrator?
And yet it would be just a few minutes before Stanley would restart the game, back in his office, as alive as ever. What exactly did the narrator think he was going to accomplish?
Do we have two narrators involved in this? Are we at the whim of some war between the forces of chaos and the forces of order? Are we a mere puppet to their whims?
When every path you can walk has been created for you long in advance, death becomes meaningless, making life the same. Do you see now? Do you see that Stanley was already dead from the moment he hit start?
What? 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 Office layout. This blueprint shows the office from the beginning of the game. The path from Stanley's office to the two doors was the first part of the game that was built. Sections have been added and altered throughout development, though the core layout remains almost identical in the first iteration. I think this is new. Moved and altered to make sure the player reaches the two doors in a good time. Music. Office computers. Oh! Oh my goodness, the credits! Oh my goodness. This is, like, I think we triggered a hidden room in the game. Yeah, I think we found the a development room. To build it was too far too jokey on the nose for the tone of the game. Plus, some people interpreted it as making fun of people like shooters, which was not our intention. Interesting. Well, we discovered something really interesting, my dear scholars. Narrator emails. After the second trailer, we asked people to email the narrator for questions, which we initially planned to use these further promotional materials. We never found the perfect use for them. Here are a section of these emails. We are literally in a museum. Cool Skeleton, you have to get going now. Have fun. Oh, thank you for coming, Cool Skeleton. It's always a pleasure to have you here.
Oh, look at these two. How they wish to destroy one another. How they wish to control one another. How they both wish to be free.
Well?
Can you see? Can you see how much they need one another?
Not really.
No, perhaps not. Sometimes these things cannot be seen. To me. You can still save those two. You can stop the program before they both fail. Push escape and press quit. Find a way to beat this game.
All right.
As long as you move forward, you'll be walking someone else's path. Stay your only true choice. To choose it.
Okay. Let's do as the voice tells us. Well, that was exciting.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
Let's keep going.
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
That was unintentional.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Okay, let's keep going.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there. Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
I have no idea how we trigger all the endings, I'll be honest.
The moment he entered his manager's office, Stanley froze in his tracks. Not a living soul anywhere. Could he really be all alone? Stanley was in such a rush to get through the story as quickly as possible, he didn't even have a single minute to just let the narrator talk. That kind of anxiety isn't healthy.
Okay.
So he relaxed for a few moments with some calming New Age music.
Well. Okay.
Feeling soothed and rejuvenated, Stanley calmly walked forward into the opened passageway.
So we've, managed still to anger the narrator even when we were trying to do exactly what he was asking us to.
Straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
Okay. Can we go back the way we came? No, we cannot. So we only have one way forward then.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out?
I think one of the things we can do here is... essentially jump off this. I don't think you can. Come on, I want to mess with the narrator some more. Ah. Fine. Union 20, time for me to go. Bye. Oh, thank you for coming, Union 20. Hope you enjoyed it.
Now the monsters jumped to life, their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen, and Stanley, one of them, eternally haunted in this place where freedom meant nothing.
It's not that much of a shock. I mean, let's be honest, how much different is this from any other business?
This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
Well.
No. He refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never! It was unthinkable, wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world?
Narrator.
But here was the proof. The heart of the operation. Controls labeled with
emotions. Oh, good
night,
Solar Coast. Thank you for coming.
Or sad, or content. Walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life. For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
Okay. Oh, can I leave the building? I cannot. Oh. Boo-hoo. Oh. Wait. Come on. Come on, let me do stuff. If I go up here. I can't get up here. Am I just stuck? I am stuck. Wonderful. Okay.
And when at last he found the source of the room's power, he knew it was his duty, his obligation, to put an end to this horrible place and to everything it stood for. Enslaved all these years, you go and you try to take control of the machine for yourself. Is that what you want? Control?
Yeah, why not?
Stanley, I help Lord Revan, I really do. But you need to understand, there's only so much that machine can do. You were supposed to let it go, turn the controls off, and leave. If you want to throw my story off track, you're going to have to do much better than that. I'm afraid you don't have nearly the power you think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find this pertinent, Stanley suddenly realized he had just initiated the network's emergency detonation system. In the event that this machine is activated without proper DNA identification, nuclear detonators are set to explode.
Oh my goodness.
How long until detonation then? This is making things a little more fun, isn't it, Stanley? It's your time to shine. You are the star. It's your story now. Shape it to your heart's desires. Oh, this is much better than what I had in mind. What a shame we have so little time left to enjoy it. Mere moments until the bomb goes off. But what precious moments each one of them is. More time to talk about you, about me, where we're going, what all this means. I barely know where to start. What's that? You'd like to know where your co-workers are? A moment of solace before you're obliterated? All right, I'm in a good mood. You're gonna die anyway. I'll tell you exactly what happened to them. I erased them. I turned off the machine. I set you free. Of course, that was merely in this instance of the story. Sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit there in your office forever, pushing buttons endlessly and then dying alone. Other times, I let the office sink into the ground, swallowing everyone inside, or I let it burn to a crisp. I have to say this, though, this version of events has been rather amusing. Watching you try to make sense of everything and take back the control wrested away from you, it's quite rich. I almost hate to see it go. But I'm sure whatever I come up with on the next go-around will be even better. My goodness, only 34 seconds left.
Oh, that's right.
But I'm enjoying this so much. You know what? To hell with it. I'm going to put some extra time on the clock. Why not? These are precious additional seconds. Time doesn't grow on trees. Oh, dear me. What's the matter, Stanley? Is it that you have no idea where you're going or what you're supposed to be doing right now? Or did you just assume when you saw that timer that something in this room was capable of turning it off? I mean, look at you. Running from button to button, screen to screen, clicking on every little thing in this room. These number buttons, no, these colored ones, or maybe this big red button, or this door. Everything, anything, something here will save me. Why don't you think that, Stanley? That this video game can be beaten? One solved? Do you have any idea what your purpose in this place is?
Oh!
Stanley, you're in for quite a disappointment. But
well,
that timer isn't a catalyst to keep the action moving along. It's just seconds ticking away to your death. You're only still playing instead of watching a cutscene because I want to watch you for every moment that you're powerless, to see you made humble. This is not a challenge, it's a tragedy. You wanted to control this world, that's fine. But I'm going to destroy it first, so you...
Wow, someone's bitter.
Take a look at the clock, Stanley. That's 30 seconds you have left to strike. 30 seconds until a big deal.
Well, my dear scholars, it was nice knowing you.
Make it count, or don't. It's all the same to me, all a part of the joke. And believe me, I will be laughing at every second of your inevitable life from the moment we see you until the moment we say
whoa! Well, that was fun, wasn't it, my dear scholars? So, I think, let's see what happens if we actually go to this the way it's supposed to be.
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
New content?
Oh, new content? What does that mean, new content?
What just happened? Oh my goodness. Did we unlock something?
Hello, and thank you for playing the Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe.
You're very welcome.
As you may know, the Stanley Parable was a video game released in 2013 on home computers.
Okay.
After receiving critical and commercial success, it was expanded upon in 2022 with the Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe, reimagining of the game for consoles and home computers.
Oh, pretty.
The Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe features exciting new content that broadens and expands the world of the Stanley Parable, delighting audiences the world over. please step inside and see what thrilling new adventures await in The Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe.
Oh, well, this sounds delightful. I'm very excited to see the thrilling new Ultra Deluxe content. Okay, so far it's an earth. Nothing special yet, but I'm sure it's just the beginning of a mesmerizing adventure.
All right.
Is it broken? What's going on here? Should we be moving somewhere or... Oh,
that's my question.
All right, finally, at long last, it's on to the new content. I've never been more ready. Let's do it.
All right. Let's do it.
I have to say, initial impressions of Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe, mostly tedious. It's as if them... Oh, okay. Let's see the content. Give me the content, Stanley. All right, let's see. It's the jump circle.
Okay. Wow, we can actually jump now. Nice. I have to agree with the narrator. It's getting a little tedious.
It? Surely that's not all the new content. There has to be something else, right? Another elevator. Stanley, I have to say, initial impressions of this game are not positive.
Well...
It's just elevators and jumping. Is this what passes for exciting new content? If this is new content, then I could just read you the whole dictionary. There's 20 hours of new content right there.
I wouldn't mind that.
I could count to 30 trillion. You could put that in the box. The Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe, now with over 1,000 hours of new content. And if... Oh, wait. There's more. Very good. Yes. I knew there had to be something else. Let's see it. I'm ready for whatever it is.
Thank you for enjoying the new content.
You've got to be kidding me. You see, Stanley? This is what happens when greedy video game developers with no respect for their fan base rush a cheap expansion to market for no reason other than to make an easy dollar. And don't get me started on the level of craftsmanship that's gone into it. In fact, I'm looking right now at the game's achievements, and it's hard to believe one of them actually says, "Test achievement, please ignore." What quality assurance department signed off on this? I'm infuriated and I'm offended. I intend to find these people on Twitter and hold them personally accountable. It's my fault, Stanley. I built up too much anticipation around the new content, I'm afraid. It could never have lived up to such expectations. Why don't we just reset the game?
Point.
And we'll try to get back to what the Stanley Parable is really about. No frills, no gimmicks. Just you and me having a great time together like always.
I don't know if I want to go back.
What do you say, friend?
The narrator even be saying these things? I don't know, Time Sage, and welcome. Oh. Oh. Things have changed. Okay.
Psst. Stanley, come over here. In the vent. I want to show you something.
Huh. I think we unlocked the new content for this game.
Okay, you remember how cheap and unsatisfying the new Ultra Deluxe content turned out to be. But it got me thinking about the past, and how much better the Stanley Parable used to be. So I made something special, and tucked it away here where the game's developers won't find it. Just our little secret. Take a look.
Whoa! Whoa. A copy machine! It's brilliant.
I call it the Memory Zone. It's where I've been storing all my favorite memories so I can relive the peak experiences of my life whenever I want. Experiences like the launch of the Stanley Parable on PC.
You see, Stanley, doesn't the Memory Zone remind you of how wonderful Stanley Parable was before it was sullied with a cheap re-release? Remember back in October of 2013, when the game originally launched? Back then, video games had integrity. Back then, it all meant something. Oh, the waste.
Excuse me, person. What was that noise? Is that a BAFTA? Why is there a dollar on the wall? Oh, I heard about that. I heard about this. There is an actual achievement you can play, you can get in Stanley Parable, if you don't play the game for 5 years. I'm not even joking. And people have gotten the achievement. It actually is a real achievement.
And over here is where I keep reviews of the Stanley Parable. Like this stunning triumph of games journalism, 10 out of 10 from Destructoid.com. James Stephanie Sterling writes, and I quote, "Where so many games that aspire to be more than games end up less than any form of art, Stanley Parable strives and then succeeds to be every game ever created." Did you hear that, Stanley? Every game ever created. That's how grand and all-encompassing the original Stanley Parable was. It was literally every game ever created. It was Skyrim. It was Persona 3. It was all of them.
Persona
and now,
3?
It's nothing. It's no games at all. It isn't even the Stanley Parable anymore. It's just a husk, Marco. A lifeless husk with an hour of new elevator content.
I can't tell if this is impressive or just sad.
Here's another moving passage, this time from GameSpot.com. "The Stanley Parable is both a richly stimulating commentary on the nature of choice in games, and one that offers some of the most enjoyable, surprising, and rewarding choices I've ever been confronted with in a game. 9 out of 10. Don't you get it, Stanley? The game was perfect. It didn't need anything else. It didn't need new content.
Okay.
It just needed to be left alone. To spend the rest of time collecting dust in the hallowed hall of beloved video game memories."
Okay. You're making me feel a little uncomfortable right now, narrator. The serious...
These were simpler times, Stanley. But I wouldn't give to go back to have it all over again. Wait, hang on. I don't recall this part of the Memory Zone before. What's this? What's down here? Oh no! Oh God, no! Stanley, it's a collection of reviews from Steam, the online video game distributor. I haven't looked at these in years. I can't even imagine what's been collecting down here.
Oh no.
Surely these reviews were glowing as well, weren't they? Honestly, I could not be bothered to play this game to full completion. The narrator is obnoxious and unfunny, with his humor and dialogue proving to be more irritating than entertaining. Unfunny! I'm a tr- trying to be funny. I'm trying to make a serious work of art. I suppose I can write up a handful of gags to insert into the Stanley Parable.
Oh,
but the game's already
lovely.
Such a densely layered web of profound philosophical insights that I can't even imagine where I'd have the room to stick them.
Oh, lovely.
Okay, let's see what this one says. While the idea for the game is good, for someone who prefers non-linear games, this preachiness gets annoying fast. Preachy? Stanley? I'm not preachy, am I?
Slightly.
You can tell me if I'm preachy. Honestly, you can. Oh, goodness. This is actually quite shocking for me. I had always thought of the game's dialogue as being rather terse to begin with. You can't know how much fluff I cut from the game to get it to feel as light and airy as it... Well, I always thought it did, but maybe it wasn't. Dear, what an awful memory to have to hold on to. These black marks on my otherwise unimpeachable track record. I feel like a failure. Like I let these people down.
Oh, you're not a failure.
Perhaps the Stanley Parable isn't quite as sterling as I always remembered. What's this one got to say? You constantly have to stop doing anything so the narrator can catch up with his long-winded explanations of what's happening. I wish there was a skip button. A skip button? Well, yes. Yes, I think we can do that. If I'm truly too preachy, then maybe letting you skip ahead for just a moment, surely it couldn't hurt. Not if it means we can strike these negative reviews from the record. Only positive reviews of the Stanley. That's my motto, and it's always been my motto. I'd do anything for the customers. Yes,
right.
A skip button we shall have. And here it is. Go ahead and give it a shot. I'll pop you forward in time so that the second my incessant droning starts to bore you with just the push of a... Oh, you're back, you see. You were only frozen in time for a few minutes, but it was plenty of time for me to deliver a long, rambling monologue full of unnecessary... Well, there's... You really did catch me rambling on a bit, didn't you?
Oh, no.
But that's the power of the button. The minute I start to go off on a thoughtless display of self-absorption, it's right at your fingertips. Okay, welcome back, Stanley. Now, I should say that the amount of time the button has been skipping through is becoming longer and longer. That last one was, well, I want to say maybe 30, 45 minutes? It's not... Stanley, please don't push the button again. It's been 12 hours. You've just been frozen there. I don't know why the skips are getting longer, but they're really, truly... Oh, Stanley, you're back. You're back. Oh, my goodness. I have someone to talk to again. Stanley, I think it's been a week. Well, 2 weeks. I've been sitting here all...
How far did we skip?
Oh, hello. It's you. You're here again. Welcome. I have had time to think about you and about us and about everything we've been through.
Okay, narrator. What's going on?
But they didn't understand. The game was never meant to be funny. It was meant to have a point. It was meant to speak to the human condition. But where are the jokes? Where are the jokes? They bemoaned. They screamed. They gnashed their teeth and said, "End."
Okay. Oh, my dear scholars, what have we got ourselves into?
The end is never the end, is never the
He's
end.
He's gone insane!
Is never the end is never the end, 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 is never the end.
He's gone insane! Can we leave? can't leave. Oh my goodness. I think this place has seen better days. To go forward. Time says this is turning into Portal 2. I agree. Now. Say we're finally free. So I'm gonna stop here for now. And we'll stop here for now. And I'll see you all in the chat area. Hello again. Horace, what do you make of all this? Yeah, I'm not sure what to make of it either. This game, it is interesting. Crusader Corrupted. Oh, hello there again. Hello there, Crusader Kinshawn. The end is never, 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 the end is never. Goodness. Dr. Zayden, the game feels like what the inside of your study might be like. Actually, that's exactly what the inside of my study is like. It's very strange. I think we have basically, at least in my mind, we have one more day's worth of a playthrough of this. I don't think we're going to get all through all 42 endings, but we at least next time can go through the main storyline and try and get that. Time Sage, your study as a narrator? One of the rooms does. It's an interesting room, actually, because when you step in, the room's narrator is your own voice. So you essentially hear yourself narrating your actions. The room is simply called Echoes. And it is, yeah, it's a very bizarre experience, I can tell you that. So, yes. I think we have, I want to say, one more playthrough of this that we can do. Kinshawn, oh, the journal room. I forgot it was called the Echoes. Yes, the journal room. It's called the Echoes as well, yeah. It's a very interesting location, if you can find it. So, Thursday, we'll be reading more of Three Men in a Boat. At least that's my plan. And next week, as long as things go according to plan, it will be the same schedule as this week, We might add another stream in. We shall see. But for now, let's see who we can raid tonight. Horace, I really need to make a new list of raid places I can raid. Oh my goodness. Let me double check this first. Raiding. Let's raid Drazov the Wicked. He is playing Myst, a game that I have never played, but heard really good things about. So then, my dear scholars, I say unto you, good evening, good morning, good afternoon, till we meet each other again at the study. Take care, and I shall see you next time. Till then, farewell, and bye-bye.